Welcome everybody, this is Poopinhammer, and we are playing Cthulhu Saves the World. This is a continuation, or a second game, after Breath of Death 7. Same art style, as you can see. We play as Cthulhu here. I'll play as... normal. Find question marks to learn more about the creation of the game. Commentary off. Countless ages, the unthinkable being known as Cthulhu has lain dormant in his underwater city of Leia? Yeah. Cthulhu, being so terrible that his mere presence is enough to drive mere mortals insane. Cthulhu sleeps while the world above goes on, oblivious to his presence. Until tonight. Awaken, great Cthulhu. As Cthulhu emerges from the bay, the world seems doomed indeed. But wait, what's that? A brave and mysterious stranger has appeared from high atop yonder cliff. Using a strange holy power, the mysterious stranger has sealed away Cthulhu's horrible power. His power drained, Cthulhu watches up on the neighboring shore, defeated and dejected. Gah! After waiting all this time to have victory snatched from my grasp by a mere mysterious man, highly frustrating. I must get my powers back, but how? Luckily for the world, Cthulhu didn't know the one only way to break the curse and regain his powers. In order to break the curse and regain his powers, he would have to do the unthinkable. He would have to become a true hero. Only by becoming a true hero would his powers return to him. Foolish narrator. While you were busy explaining the situation to the player, I was eavesdropping. Now I do know the way to regain my power. Whoops. I, Cthulhu, do hereby vow to devote my life to becoming a true hero. Only so that I can regain my powers. Summon Relay to the... surface, and destroy the world, of course. And thus, a most unlikely hero was born. Welcome to your new life as a wannabe RPG hero. Before we begin, allow me to give you a few pointers. The great Cthulhu needs no assistance! However, for the benefit of the lowly player who dares control me, I will allow you to continue with your few tips. Feed while moving to run fast. Wahaha, foolish game developer! I can even be able to run, often to steal the game in half the time. I'll be able to sell it back to the game store before the trade-in value drops. Yeah, that's not gonna happen. So the wide open menu. From here you can chat with members, your party, check out their stats, and I know. Teleport back to cities you visited. Oh, that's nice. I can save it any time? Is this first-person shooter? Hahaha. Inside chat. The ability is like insanity slash in common. Enemies insane, enemies take more damage from attacks, but watch out, a few enemies become more dangerous when insane. There'll be no watching out. I shall bestow the gift of insanity upon all! Blunder combo, count with hits, unleash, okay, it's the same deal as Breath of Death. You done yet? So if you would like to actually play this game sometime this year, good luck! Cosmic monstrosities don't need luck! We forge our own destinies, no matter what the cost to humanity. Alright. 1-ups. We use 1-ups to reset and fail the battle. Alright. Sure. Aha! A helpless maiden beset by vicious monsters. I shall rescue her, thus becoming a true hero. That would work for a normal person, but you have a lot of evil to hope for. It will take more heroic deeds before you're even remotely close to being considered a true hero. Then I will kill the monsters anyway, just for the sake of violence. Attack, got the insanity thing. Whoops. 28. Booze is insane. Let's just. Okay, I'll attack him. Boom. Victory. Level to level 4. When that happened. Alright, insane strength. It's insane. Each insane enemy gives strength. Same man. Okay, so I'm more than. I'm gonna go with a. There we go. Die, foul slime monsters! With the defeat of the final slime monster, he turned his gaze to the maiden he had rescued.
Gorgeous!
What? he gazed upon the mighty Cthulhu. She did not see a crazed Occubus dragon man. Instead, she saw this. Warning, image displayed may not reflect reality.
My hero!
Hero indeed. Do you hear that? Do I count as a true hero yet? No. This rate I shall never become a true hero and regain my cosmic powers of destruction.
Oh, brave warrior who saved me from a gooey death, let me join you on your noble quest.
Do you do anything besides getting attacked by slime monsters?
I have an affinity for the creatures of the sea. Call them my friends.
Pass.
Oh, and I have this trident which I use to stab things.
That's more like it.
And above all, I, Umi, promise you my wholehearted love and devotion, you great big green hunk of handsomeness.
Yes, the great Cthulhu requires groupies. You shall do.
Yay! Does that mean we're dating now?
No, we're in a strictly rockstar groupie relationship.
For now.
Umi has joined the party. Now you're the second party member. You can use the chat function. Let's use multi-carry unite. Alright, same deal. We're now active in this dungeon after fighting 25 there. Okay. So it's explaining more of the system that it did not do in Breath of Death. Alright. Town of Miskatonia. It's just past a series of caves. I'm sure there are some heroic deeds you could do there. To Miskatona! Stun rate 100% once per battle. Oh, we have actual things. Okay. Sure. Let's flood. Those gulls. And it was dead. I forgot about that, yeah. When it gets there, we'll back. Hide. Has ability less likely to be attacked by enemy. Yeah, we're gonna go by that. So she's the healer. It seems like they definitely buffed up the level bonuses. Fleece tunic. Exactly what I want. bad potions. Yeah, after playing the Breath of Death series for this, it's definitely a lot easier to get into the groove. Attack you. Early on what you want to make each character. Like, Umi is definitely the healer. So everything I do should make her better at healing. Stanley Uzumaki.
Wrongs and triumph over evil. That means you. Switchblade, the main. I'm here to steal from the wicked. Give to the chest.
I'm Dash the Daring. My courage is only rivaled by my good looks. We are the three heroes of goodly justice. Dark Fiend Cthulhu, we will defeat you and restore light to the world.
You're a Dark Fiend? You should have told me. That's so sexy.
See you using your vile magic to ensnare that beautiful maiden. Release her.
Please. If I was using my magic to ensnare someone, I would pick someone much hotter. Hey!
Yo, narrator. Do I get hero points for defeating annoying heroes?
No.
Well, I'm going to beat them up anyway.
Virtue always triumphs over evil. Or should we?
Your friend over there doesn't look too
virtuous. Hiding behind that cloak and all.
I have a skin condition. Leave me alone.
Puny humans. Even with my powers locked away, I have more than enough power to deal with you. Prepare to be defeated.
Cleric, a hero, and a thief appear. Well, I think we know what to do here. Attack the healer. Ouch. Death blow. Danny's dead. Let's retry. Okay. It's a terrible way to start the battle here. Same strike. Blood. Alright. Kill the cleric. You're dead. Deathblow. Thief to kill him. Really? Just you and me, suck a duck. That was insane! Everybody attack or a single person attack? Attack or just does, I think, doing damage with a chance of blind is better. So we'll do that.
Cthulhu 1, lame hero 0.
I hope they're okay.
The adventurers, wouldn't worry about it. Probably already
respawn at the nearest church. Dragon Quest. Wonder if we'll meet them again. Probably. Enough contemplation. Onward to heroism. First battle. But I guess it's better than not using them at all, ever. Right? Things are like, this is the right way. Going down, I don't know. This is an iron sword. Excellent. Better. Well, that will probably do it for today. I'm gonna use the remaining 13 battles and just get some levels. Anything interesting, I'll just let you know at the beginning of next episode. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I hope you enjoy Cthulhu Saves the World.